Hi, welcome back to Let's Get Fit. I'm Sandy Morvillo, your host, and today we're going to be going over abs of steel. How do you get them? This whole workout is going to develop around just your core. How do you get to this midsection to be the strongest part of your body? It only takes about 15 to 20 minutes a day, 3 or 4 times a week, or as many days as you can handle it. If only one time a week works for you, then that's what you should do. This is a really great way to enhance the rest of your workout and your whole fitness. So what you need today is just a mat or a towel, the floor, yourself. And if you have a weight, I would suggest 3 pounds or less. I have a 5 pound plate and I also have a 3 pound dumbbell. If you don't have any weights, you can use a water bottle from home, or you don't need any weight at all. You can just use your own body weight. Let's get started. I'm gonna start with a 5 pound plate. You can use a dumbbell if you prefer, or your water bottle here. We're gonna stand with the plates up over your head, your elbows are in, and we're gonna alternate, so you're taking your elbows in towards your chest by curling your abs in. So you're curling this way, so you're curling your abs in, but at the same time, you're gonna take your knee and meet your elbow in the center. We're gonna do this for 30 seconds. Here we go, 1, 2, good. Now you can count if you want to, but you don't have to. You can use a clock or an egg timer. I'm a big advocate of using a timer so you don't have to worry about your watch and keeping an eye on the clock. You can count if you want to. End up, pull, end up. Now, let's just pick up the tempo. 1, 2, 3, pull. Good. 4, you're just warming up those abs. 5, 6, 7, you can keep it slow if you prefer, 8, we're going to go to 10, 9, and 10. So we're warming up those front of the abdominals here. Now hold your plate or your dumbbell like a wheel, like you would in a car wheel, and you're going to take your weight and pull it into your side. So I'm keeping my hips, my knees bent, my hips forward. I'm going to pull my weight in, leading with my right elbow into my side and crunching in on that right side. And I'm gonna do that 10 times to the right. 1, and up. 2, and center. 3, and up. 4, good. 5, so you're gonna bend into it. 6, good. Cross that left shoulder. 7, 8, 9, and then go 10 times to your left. 1, and up. 2, and up. 3, good. 4, really squeeze hard as you're doing these. 5, and up. 6, and up. 7, up. 8, try not to twist your body. 9, just from your torso, and 10. So what you don't want to do here is buckle your knees in and out. You can bend your knees slightly to take the pressure off of your knee, but the work is coming from the pull in here on your oblique and from your abs. Let's go from the beginning again. Ready? We're just gonna do 10. Knees to the chest. 1. Good. 2. Good. 3. Nice and slow at first. That's it. Pull those elbows in. Knees come up and down. Lift and lower. Lift. Good. Now let's pick up the tempo for 10. 1. 2. 3. Good. 4, that's it. 5, squeeze, squeeze. 6, that's it. 8, 9, 10, and relax. Going to the right side again, pull it in. 1, 2, 3. Now I'm making the movement a little bit bigger here. If you feel confident with this pull to the right, pull it right back over that left shoulder. Make this twist a little bit bigger. If you have issues with your back, 2 more, 1 more, good. Now take it to your left side. If you have issues with your back, I wouldn't suggest doing a big twist here. Just keep it to the one side and don't pull it back over your shoulder. If you get dizzy, just keep your head forward. And up, pull, 4 more, 4, good. 3, up, 2, up, and 1. Good job. Let's do one more set from the top here. Ready, knees up, slow. Pull, up, pull, lift, squeeze, up, squeeze, up. Good. You're bringing that knee right down, elbows come in. Pull and lift, pull and lift. Pull, lift, tempo this for 8. 1, 2, good. Keep it slow if you prefer. That's it, 4 more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Taking it to your right. Here we go. 1, 2, push it up. 3, and pull. 4, good job. 5, leave with that elbow. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now switch sides. 1, pull. 2, if your core isn't strong, you will never be the athlete that you want to be. You will never have the fitness level that you want. Your core is your center. It has to be strong. 2 more, and 1. Great job. It's the center of everything. So it makes it, it's really, really important. And you don't have to always just do the same basic crunches, especially if you're someone who has a lot of neck issues. That kind of workout, what we just did, is really good for you because you're not putting any stress on your neck at all. Okay, so let's take it down. We're gonna do some basic crunches here. For those of you who love the old school crunches, this is what we're gonna do. So we're doing a regular crunch and we're gonna superset with a lying plank crunch. So what this is you can either use your plate or the weight. The first crunch, we're just gonna do regular crunches. You're coming up, your hands at the side of your head, just barely touching your head. You never clasp your hands behind your head because you put too much stress here. You don't want to pull your head. You want to just guide your head up, resting your head so that your neck is relaxed. Or you can place your hands here on top of your shoulders and lead here. But it's all working from the abdomen. Do not have the work come from your neck. The second thing we're going to do is an overhead lying press here. So you're going to put one foot on top of the other, and you don't have to use a weight, or you can, and you're just going to come up and use that little bit of weight to work those abs and that long extension. So let's start off first with a regular crunch. Feet are flat on the floor, elbows out to the side. Ready? Lead with your shoulders. Here we go. Lift and down. Lift. Lift. Good. So you're just crunching. You're making your rib cage come closer together. Shoulder blades are coming up, off the floor, press and down. 6 and lower. Exhale up, inhale down. Good job. That's it. 5 more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it all the way down. Place your left foot straight and your right foot on top of your left foot. Arms over your head and lift. Keep those elbows behind your ears. 2. So keep your elbows behind your head. Good. Julie, try to keep your elbows back a little bit more. That's it. It's a small range of movement here. It's a very small movement. Your elbows need to stay back behind your ears. Palms facing up toward the ceiling. You do not have to use a weight if you don't want to. Good. And down. Small and lower. Press and down. Really working that whole length of the abdomen here. 5 more. 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Okay, bring that weight in. Feet are flat, elbows out to the side, and crunch it. 1. Good job. 2. Keep breathing. One of the most important things that we make a mistake, that's the most important, and we make mistakes all the time, and when we're doing abs, is to hold our breath. And it's very important to breathe. It will help you through the workout, I promise. Pressing that lower back into the floor once again, like with any other workout, if it hurts your lower back, you can lift those legs. It'll help to flatten that back to the floor. Let's do 5 more. 4, good. 3, 2, and 1. Feet are out straight, arms over your head. Ready? Here we go. We're supersetting here. We're not giving those abs a rest. 3, good. 4, 5, 6, keep breathing, 7, 8, 9, 10. You feeling it yet? 5 more, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Pull those weights back in. We're going to do one more set here. Here we go. Lift and down. Good. Keep that contraction here. That means pull your belly button into the back of your spine and then don't let it go. So you're not resting every time you're coming back. You're not just letting go and resting. It's not a rest time. You're keeping those abs contracted and you're working the whole time. I know it's difficult, but that's how they get stronger. Use your breath to get you through it. Let's do 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Legs are out straight, arms up over your head. Ready, last set. 1, good. 2, pull your rib cage in. Belly buttons to the back of the spine. If your neck is bothering you, you can bend from one hand here and place your head right on your forearm or get rid of the weight. Press and down. Press down. 5 more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Slowly roll it all the way up. Sit up nice and tall. How are we doing? Okay, let's go right into some toe taps. So we're gonna go right into a plank here. And on a plank, your elbows are gonna come right underneath your shoulders. Your toes are tucked under and you're gonna lift so that you're nice and straight, abs are in. I'd rather have your butt be up a little bit too high than to have it sink down low. So you wanna come either straight across, make sure your elbows are under, or bring your butt up slightly. You don't want to sink in the middle. It puts a lot of stress on your back. Now take your right toe and tap right and left. So we're just going to tap. 1, back. 2, back. 3. Now if you don't want to tap, if that feels like too much on your abdomen, then don't tap. Just hold that plank position. Good. 4 more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Come down to your knees. How did we do with that one? Okay. So here, what we're going to do is come on to our elbow. Okay. The first set, I'm not going to use any weight at all. So once again, just like what we just did with the plank, make sure your elbow is right underneath your shoulder. You're going to lift. Your bottom foot is going to stay on the ground, knee bent. Lift your hip, and then you might have to readjust. So that you're up, your hip is up off the ground, your top leg is straight. Your left arm is going to reach forward, taking that top arm, reach it underneath, and pull. 1, 2. So you're twisting behind you. 3, and pull. 4, and pull. 5, 6, 7. Once again. 8. If this feels like too much turning, then just hold it here. And 10. Now drop your hip, pivot around, do a little sit and spin here. Good. Make sure that elbow is right underneath your shoulder. Bottom knee is down, lift your hip, right arm is up. Take it down and lift. Down and lift. If you don't want to turn, just hold it here. Hold that side plank and lift. Great job. Good. 5 more. 4, 3, push, 2, push, and 1. Great job. Let's turn right into our hands here. Going right up into that side plank again. I'm going to bring it up. Make sure your elbows are right underneath your shoulders. Abs are in tight. Tap the toes, right, left. 1, 2, and back. 3, back. 4, good. 5, how we doing? 6, back. 7, 8, good job. 9, and 10. Bring it down, turn it over, Left elbow is underneath. Lift up your hip. Take that right hand. Now I'm going to grab my 3-pound weight and I'm going to pull that through. 1, 2, good. 3, 4, 5, good job. 6, 7, 8, 9, hip up, and 10. Do a little sit and spin. Make sure you keep that hip up the whole time. Otherwise, you're gonna put a lot of stress on that shoulder and on your lower back and not work your abdomen the way we want it to. So we're gonna lift up that hip first. Arm is forward and pull through. 1, 2, good job. 3, 4, 5, looks good. 6, remember you can keep it and hold it center if you just wanna hold that side plank. You don't have to do this pivot. 9 and 10. Last set here, come into that same plank position, up onto your toes, tap it out, right, left. 1, back, 2, 3, good job. 4, abs are in. 5, good. 6, it's challenging. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good job. Come back up onto that right shoulder. Knee is down, top leg is straight. Lift your hip, grab your weight. Ready, here we go. How you doing with this? 2, okay. 3, awfully quiet. 4, 5, good. 6, up. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good job, everybody. Stay with us now. Switch sides. Left elbow is down, right leg is up. Lift that hip, same thing, reach it through. 1, 2, and up. 3, 4, hips are squared off. 5, 6, pull it up. 7, 8, 9, you're gonna feel this tomorrow. And 10, great job. Okay, we've got one more thing and then you guys are out of here. Quick workout for those abs. We're gonna do some knee planks. So this time we're gonna do it up at a high plank. Your hands are gonna be right underneath your shoulders. Come back up onto your toes. Make sure you're nice and straight here. Once again, we don't want you sinking. We're gonna pull those hips up, abs are in, knee comes to the elbow, in and back, in and back. Let's do 10 and back, in and back. Good job. Hold that position. You got it. Are you breathing? Slow and control. We're going to do 4 more. 4 and back. 2 and 1. Now holding a high side plank, just turn to your side. This is one option. Okay. Another option is to come back into that lower position that we were in before. You can do it this way. Hold it up. 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna turn it, do a little sit and spin again because we wanna get both sides. Feet together, hand underneath that shoulder, and lift. Hold it up. Good. Squeeze, hold that hip up. Try not to let your hip sink. Hold it up. Squeeze. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, now let's pivot back to the center. Knees come in, left, right. 1, 2, good. 3. So basically we're doing just what we did for that warm up when we're standing, only we're in a different position here. Gravity's working a little bit more against us. That's it. 2 more, 1 more, and relax. Turn and pivot. Right hand is down, left arm is up. Squeeze and hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I've got some shaking going on here too. So if you're shaking, don't worry about it. That just means that your muscle is fatiguing. Go to the other side. Sit.
reduce that arm up. Good. Now, if you feel better, you can keep your head forward. You don't have to lift your arm. You can keep it here on your hip. Whatever works. Hold it. Four. Three. Two. One. Last set. Here we go. Right, left knee. Come on. Pull. You're doing great. It doesn't take much. And you don't have to do all 100 zillion crunches to work that core. Although crunches work, it's more fun to mix it up. One more, and relax. Turn it to your side. Your left arm is down, reach it up, hip is up. Keep that hip up, squeeze. Woo! Four more, four, three, two, and one. Great job. Switch sides. Swing it around. Right hand is down, left arm is up. Squeeze that right hip up. Hang on to it. Breathe. Four more. Four, three, two, and one. Great job. Bring it back to the center. Woo! You're done. Let's roll it all the way down, nice and easy. Pull those knees into our back, into our chest. Let our back go nice and flat onto the floor. So you can see, it doesn't take that long. Not that much time. A few times a week for 10, 15, 20 minutes, changing up the exercises. Slowly round it all the way up. You can mix it up however you like to. We're going to turn slightly to the right and open up that torso. Chest is up and open. Keep breathing. How'd you do? Okay? Turn to the other side. Good. Hold that stretch. And bring it center. Push it all the way up. Hands are down. We're going to roll it. Just hold this position with your hands dangling by your feet. Let your spine drop. Open up. Bend your knees slightly and round it. Good. Shoulders back and down. Take a nice deep breath up. Exhale to your left. And bring it center. And exhale to your right. And bring it center. We're going to roll it down one more time. Flat back. Round it up. Shoulders back and down. Have a great day. We'll see you next time on Let's Get Fit. Thank you.